The cross product, level 5. In this video, we will go over and prove various algebraic properties of the cross product. Let's start with the first algebraic property. Let U, V, and W be vectors in space, and let C be a scalar. Then, vector U crossed with vector V is equal to the negative of vector V crossed with vector U. In other words, the cross product is anti-commutative. This property tells us that both vectors have the same length, but opposite directions. This and subsequent properties can be proved by writing the vectors in terms of their components and using the component definition of the cross product. So we will let vector U be equal to the following components, and let vector V be equal to the following components. Then, by using the component definition of the cross product, we go ahead and set up our determinant and find the minors of the matrix. We then find an expression for the determinant of each 2x2 matrix. Simplifying the expression, we obtain the following for the cross product between vector U and vector V. Next, we do the same and use the component definition of the cross product to find vector V crossed with vector U. Doing that, we obtain the following expression for the components of vector V crossed with vector U. Taking a look at the two vectors, we see that the expression on the right can be obtained by multiplying the expression on the left by the scalar negative 1, as follows. And this ends the proof. Let's take a look at the next property. Vector U crossed with the sum of vector V and vector W is equal to vector U crossed with vector V plus vector U crossed with vector W. In other words, the cross product is distributive over addition. To prove this property, we write vector U, V, and W in component form and find an expression for the components for both the left and right-hand side of the expression. Let's start with the left-hand side. We first add vector V with vector W. Doing that, we obtain the following components. Then, we go ahead and find the cross product between vector U and the sum of vector V and vector W. Doing that, we obtain the following components. Next, we go ahead and distribute the components of vector U, obtaining the following. Now we go ahead and do the same for the right-hand side of the expression. So we first find vector U crossed with vector V, obtaining the following expression. Then we find vector U crossed with vector W, obtaining the following expression. We go ahead and add these two vectors together and compare it to the left-hand side. Notice that every single component on the right side matches with its corresponding component on the left-hand side. Thus, both sides are equivalent, and this ends the proof. Let's take a look at the third property. Scalar C times vector U crossed with vector V is equal to scalar C times vector U crossed with vector V, which is also equal to vector U crossed with scalar C times vector V. When multiplying by a scalar, you are free to multiply any of the two vectors and proceed with the cross product. Let's move along to the next property. Vector U crossed with the zero vector is equal to the zero vector crossed with vector U, which is equal to the zero vector. So a vector crossed with the zero vector is essentially equal to the zero vector. The fifth property is vector U crossed with itself is also equal to the zero vector. We can easily prove this by representing vector U in component form and finding the cross product. Notice that the value of each component reduces to zero. Recall that this is the definition of the zero vector. And this ends the proof. The sixth property is vector U dotted with the cross product of vector V with vector W is equal to the cross product between vector u and vector v, dotted with vector w. In other words, this represents an exchange of dot and cross product. The expression on the left-hand side of this property is also known as a scalar triple product, or triple scalar product. We will talk about this property in more detail in a later video. The proof of this property is very similar to the previous proofs. We go ahead and denote each vector in component form. Then, we work with the left-hand side and find an expression in terms of these components, and do the same for the right side of the expression. In the end, both the left and right side should have identical expressions for their components. So let's start with the left-hand side and find the cross product between vector v and vector w. We then take this vector and dot it with vector u. Then, we go ahead and distribute the components of vector u as follows. Next, we work with the right-hand side and find the cross product between vector u and vector v, obtaining the following vector. Then, we dot this vector with vector w, obtaining the following expression, making sure we also distribute the components of vector w. Notice that each of the terms on the right side can be found on the left side of the expression. So this property has been verified. And this ends the proof. The last property is vector u crossed with the cross product between vector v and vector w is equal to the dot product of vector u with vector w times vector v minus the dot product between vector u and vector v times vector w. The expression on the left-hand side of this property is also known as the vector triple product, or triple vector product. Alright, and these are the 6 algebraic properties of the cross product that you should be familiar with. They will be very useful when solving various types of problems and when you need to derive certain expressions in the fields of mathematics and science. Alright, let's go over a couple examples that make use of these algebraic properties. Given vector A and vector B, find vector A crossed with vector B and vector B crossed with vector A. Alright, we're given vector A and vector B in component form, and we are asked to find 2 separate cross products. Let's use the component definition of the cross product. So let's set up our 3x3 determinant and find the minor for each component. Next, let's compute the determinant of each 2x2 matrix. And then, we simplify, obtaining the following vectors for each cross product. Notice that the cross product is not commutative and is order sensitive. In fact, it is anti-commutative. Recall that this was one of the algebraic properties of the cross product. Alright, let's try the next example. Given vector A, vector B, and vector C, show that vector A crossed with the cross product between vector B and vector C is not equal to the cross product between vector A and vector B crossed with vector C. The simplest way to show that both operations are not equal is by simply computing the left and right-hand side and directly compare the results of both operations. Let's start by computing the left side first. So we first find an expression for vector B crossed with vector C. Then we take vector A and cross it with this vector. Doing that, we obtain the following vector. Next, we do the same for the right-hand side. So we first find vector A crossed with vector B. Doing that, we obtain the following vector. Next, we take this vector and cross it with vector C, obtaining the following vector. Taking a look at both vectors, we see that they are not equal to one another. This example illustrates that the cross product is not associative. Alright, Let's go over the next example. Verify Lagrange's identity if vector A and vector B are in R cubed. Alright, we will let theta be the angle formed between vector A and vector B. Then, the dot product on the right side of the identity can be written as the magnitude of vector A times the magnitude of vector B times cosine of theta. This is essentially the geometric definition of the dot product. Next, we use the property of exponents to rewrite this expression as follows. Then, we can go ahead and factor out the common factor as follows. We can now use a Pythagorean identity and replace the 1 minus cosine of theta squared term with sine of theta squared. Doing that, we obtain the following. Notice that this expression is nothing more than the magnitude of the cross product between vector A and vector B squared. And this ends the proof. This identity will be useful to prove the geometric property of the cross product in the next video. Alright, let's go over the final example. Prove vector A minus vector B crossed with vector A plus vector B is equal to 2 times vector A crossed with vector B. Alright, let's work with the left side of the expression. We will first apply the distributive property for cross products and expand the left side of the expression as follows. Making sure we do not change the order of the cross products, since the cross product is not commutative. Here, vector A crossed with vector A and vector B crossed with vector B reduces to the zero vector. The last two cross products are related to one another, since one expression is just the negative with the order of the vectors reversed. Replacing this second expression, we obtain the following. Simplifying the expression, we obtain 2 times vector A crossed with vector B. And this ends the proof. Alright, in our next video, we will go over the geometric properties of the cross product.